There's your wall of worry. Let's bring in a guy who can just swing the bat and try to knock down everything we're seeing there. Chad Morganlander, portfolio manager at Washington Crossing Advisors. He's thinking. He looks very serious right now. When you look at that wall of worry, Chad, which one of those is to you the biggest thing to maybe really be concerned about, and which of that on the wall may be complete fake news?
Well, for me, it's the emerging markets as well as rising interest rates. My general concern about that is that when it comes to the emerging markets, about 65 to 70% of global growth over the last decade has come from the EM side, in particular China. And then when you look at the rate environment, as you start to see rates rise, that becomes much more of a competitive asset class to equities.
Isn't it amazing? I was just standing over there, and now I'm sitting here. It's the power. Maybe there's two of me, like that movie, The Prestige. I think I just ruined that movie. Okay, so number one is emerging markets.
Absolutely.
It's not rates. It's not inflation.
Well, it is. That's a second concern I have.
I mean, they're all kind of tied,
it's
right?
It's all tied together.
Emerging markets also get whacked by inflationary concerns and rates here, do they not?
They do. But keep in mind that when it comes to the U.S. equity markets, if we're talking about the stock market, okay, that is tied towards earnings and revenue growth. And if the emerging markets and global growth decelerate rapidly, if that happens, then that will affect U.S. multinationals and U.S. corporations.
Which of those do you not worry about at all? We've got China trade war, midterm, maybe it's the midterm elections. Is that in your sort of sights when you do your analysis on the markets?
Well, midterm elections, that's something that doesn't concern us, because even if the Democrats get the House, we think that overall the U.S. economy is going to, at least over the next 12 months, be okay-ish with a 2.5% growth on GDP. Oil and gas, it's at a spot here where we don't think that will sap from U.S. consumption for consumers, nor will it derail the global growth environment. Really, it comes down to a couple of things here. The rate environment, as well as how fast the U.S. economy and the global economy will go higher or decelerate. Those are the two critical levers that will push and pull at the U.S.
Well, let me push back a little bit here.
Sure.
There's a school of thought out there that if the House goes to the Democrats, Senate remains Republican, that it's a good thing for everybody because now they just can just fight amongst themselves and we can go on with our lives. Mm-hmm. If they both turn Democrat, there's another school of thought, which is they're going to try to roll back a lot of the things that the president and the current Congress have done that may be contributing to our recent market rally, which means stocks could turn down.
So the critical thing to view there is what will happen to the U.S. budget. And what we're thinking, and we're following the CBO's analysis on this, is that you're going to continue to see deficit spending over the next 36 to 48 months. And it's going to be a rather wide deficit of 4 to 5%, which generally doesn't happen in an expansionary time period. Hence the reason why we still continue to think that that's going to go through over that period of time. So we're generally not concerned about that as of yet.
Because politicians of both parties get elected by promising to give people things, not take things away.
No doubt. Exactly right, Brian.
All right.